Good day, exceptional grade 11 learners. I know you are getting so excited as we grab another blast of sharpening your knowledge and understanding in computer system servicing. Another word today is set to be peppered with knowledge and fun. I am your teacher, Albert Arellano Luba, your always on the go learning buddy from Santa Teresita National High School. We are now on the second to the last video lesson in our core competency number one, which is installing and configuring computer systems. In learning competency number one, which is assembling computer hardware. Welcome, dear learners.
My dear learners, our content standard for this lesson, installing and configuring computer system, is you, our dear learners, will demonstrate an understanding of concepts and principles in installing and configuring computer systems. Our performance standard is you, our dear learners, shall be able to install and configure computer systems based on established procedures and system requirements. Our learning competencies and learning code is you are going to assemble computer hardware. Our learning objectives for this video lessons are the following. A. Identify the different types and features of motherboards, specifically the sockets, chipsets, PCI, and AGP. And letter B. You are going to identify the different parts of motherboard. My dear learners, let's take a recap in our last lesson. In the last chapter, you learned about the form factors and different types of computer cases. You also learned about the basic parts of system unit. In this chapter, we build on that knowledge to learn about motherboards, which tech is sometimes called MOBO. A motherboard is the most complicated component in computer. When you put together a computer from parts, generally, you start with deciding on which processor and motherboard you will use. Everything else follows those decisions. My dear learners, take a look at the details of Figure 3.1, which shows a motherboard designed with gamers in mind. If you were shopping for a motherboard for a gaming system, you'd have to compare many features among numerous boards. Generally, you'd need to pay attention to form factor, processor sockets, chipsets, buses, and number of bus slots, and other connectors, slot, and ports. In this part of the lesson, we'll look at the detail of each this feature so that in future, you'll be able to read MOBO ad with knowledge of a pro. We also look at how configuration information is stored on a motherboard. To summarize, recall that a motherboard form factor determines the size of the board and its features that make it compatible with power supplies, cases, processors, and expansion cards. The most popular motherboard form factors are the ATX, Micro ATX, and BTX. Here, we have the Intel DX58SO motherboard is designed with the gamer in mind. Another, this is a Micro ATX motherboard by BioStar and has an AM2 socket that supports an AMD processor. And a BTX motherboard with an LGA775 LAN socket that supports an Intel processor. Another important feature of a motherboard is a processor socket. This socket and the chipset determines which processors a board can support. A socket will hold either an Intel or AMD processor. Some older processors were installed on the motherboard in a long narrow slot, but all processors sold today use sockets. Now, my dear learners, let's take a look at the Intel processor sockets. We have here the LGA 1366, or we called it socket B. It is used by Core i7 and has a description of 1366 pins that touch pads on the processor. It works with DDR3 memory, and it is expected to replace LGA 771 and LGA 775 sockets. Next processor socket is the Intel socket name, LGA 771, or the socket J. It uses a Core 2 Extreme and has a description of 771 pins that touch pads on the processor. It used on high-end workstations and low-end servers. It works with DDR2 memory on boards that have two processor sockets. Next Intel socket is the socket LGA 775, or the socket T. It uses a processor like Core 2 Extreme, Core 2 Quad, Core 2 Duo, Pentium Dual Core, Pentium Extreme Edition, Pentium 4, and many Celeron processors. It has a description of 775 LANs or pads. It works with DDR3 and a DDR2 memory. Next Intel processor socket is the Intel socket 478. It uses a processor family using Pentium 4 or Celeron processors. It has a description of 478 holes for pins. It uses a dense micro PGA, or the MPGA. It's no longer sold. Next Intel motherboard processor socket is the Intel socket 423. It uses a processor family, Pentium 4, and it has a description of 423 holes for pins, and it has a 39x39 SPGA grid. It is no longer sold. Now, my dear learners, let's also take a look at the AMD processor sockets. First is the AM3, or the AMD3 processor AMD sockets. It uses a processor family, Phantom 2, and it has a description of 938 holes for pins. Works with DDR3 memory. Next, AMD processor is the processor socket AM2 Plus, or AMD 2 Plus. It has a Phantom 2, or Phantom and Athlon processor. It has also a description of 940 holes for pins. Works with DDR2 memory and faster than AMD 2. Next type of an AMD processor socket is the processor socket AM2, or AMD 2 processor. It uses a processor family, Athlon and Sempron. It has a description of 940 holes for pins. It works with DDR2 memory. Next AMD processor socket is the processor socket 754. It uses a processor family, Athlon and Sempron, and it has a description of 754 holes for pins and works with DDR memory. Next AMD processor socket is the socket 940. It uses an Athlon processor and it has a description of 940 holes for pins. It works with DDR memory. Next AMD socket processor is the processor socket 939. It uses a processor Athlon and Sempron, and it has a description of 939 holes for pins. It works with DDR memory
but it is no longer so.
Next, AMD processor socket is the processor socket A. It uses processor family Athlon, Sempron, and Duron. It has a description of 462 holes for pins, and it works with DDR memory, but it rarely sold today. In this processor socket, you are looking at the processor socket of AM2 Plus socket, and it uses an AMD Athlon 64 processor. Now, my dear learners, let's talk about the PGA and LGA socket. PGA stands for the word pin grid array socket. It has pins aligned in uniform rows around the socket. Small pins can easily be bent as the processor is installed in the socket. Later, Intel sockets use a LAN grid array or LGA that uses LANs rather than pins. The first LGA socket is the LGA775 socket. Next part of the motherboard is the chipset. A few motherboard manufacturers, such as Intel and AMD, make their own chipsets. The major chipset manufacturers are the Intel and AMD. Now, let's take a look at the chipsets of the motherboard. So, we have here the Southbridge and the Northbridge.
One of the main and one of the most important components you'll find on a motherboard is the chipset. Older motherboards were designed with a lot of different chips scattered all over the motherboard. There were chips for different things, like chips for bus controllers, memory controllers, keyboard controllers, and so on. So they had a lot of different chips controlling different functions on the motherboard. So as technology progressed, computer engineers decided to reduce the number of chips and have them more in a centralized location. So instead of having these different chips scattered all over the motherboard controlling different functions, they reduced the number of chips to do the same job and condensed them to only a few chips, or what's now called a chipset. And that's what a chipset is. A chipset is a smaller set of chips that has replaced a larger amount of chips. And the chipset's job is to control data flow between the CPU, the peripherals, bus slots, and memory. So all of the different parts of the computer communicate with the CPU through the chipset. The chipset basically consists of two chips. One is called the Northbridge, and the other is called the Southbridge. The Northbridge is located in the upper or northern part of the motherboard, providing you're looking at the motherboard in the upright position. It's located near the CPU and is directly connected to the CPU. It's also directly connected to the memory and the AGP and PCI Express slots. So in order for the CPU to communicate with the memory and the AGP or PCI Express bus, it has to go through the Northbridge first. So the Northbridge acts like a communication middleman between a CPU, AGP or PCI Express, and memory. The other chip is called the Southbridge. And the Southbridge is located at the bottom or southern portion of the motherboard, near the PCI bus slots. The Southbridge connects to the PCI bus slots, SATA and IDE connectors, and USB ports. So the Southbridge is responsible for the lower portion of the motherboard, while the Northbridge is responsible for the upper portion. There is no direct connection between the CPU and the lower portion of the motherboard. So if the PCI, USB, IDE, or SATA ports needed to communicate with the CPU The information has to go through the south bridge, and then up through the north bridge, and then to the CPU. The north bridge is faster than the south bridge, and that's because the CPU, the PCIe, AGP, and memory are the most used and most important components of the motherboard, so they need to operate at the highest speeds possible. The slower south bridge communicates with the PCI bus, SATA and IDE connectors, and USB ports, and they don't need to be as fast as the other components. So basically, the higher speed components are connected to the north bridge, and the slower components are connected to the south bridge. Now, both the north and south bridge make these connections to various parts of the motherboard using pathways called a bus. And a bus is simply a set of pathways that allows data and signals to travel between components on the motherboard. The motherboard contains several kinds of buses that vary in speed and bandwidth. So for example, if a bus speed is said to operate at 66 MHz, then that means that that particular bus can send data at 66 million cycles per second. The higher the bus speed, the faster the computer can send data, which improves the performance of the computer. A motherboard's bus speed generally refers to the speed of the frontside bus. The frontside bus is the connection between the CPU and the Northbridge chipset.
Okay, my dear learners, that ends the motherboard chipsets. Before proceeding to the next topic, let me check first what is your understanding about the chipsets. Okay, my dear learners, this is the direction. Answer the following statements. Please type your answer in the link provided to you. Now, this is the question. Give the functions of the north bridge and the south bridge. I repeat, give the functions of the north bridge and the south bridge. I will give you 2 minutes to answer the question. I repeat, I will give you 2 minutes to answer the question. Your timer starts now. AGP bus. AGP stands for the word Accelerated Graphics Port. A motherboard video slots and video cards use the accelerated graphic ports, standards for many years. But AGP has the most been replaced by PCI Express. Even though AGP is dying technology. Now, let's take a look at the 6 types of the AGP buses. First one is the AGP 3.3 volt slot. Next, the AGP 1.5 volt slot. Third is the AGP universal slot. So as you can see, there are no notches in the slot. Next, number 4, the AGP Pro Universal Slot. Next is the AGP Pro 3.3 volt slot. And the AGP Pro 1.5 volt slot. So there you have it, my dear students, the 6 type of AGP buses. Okay, my dear learners, it's time for the self-check 1.3. So you are going to identify the different motherboard PCI and AGP buses. Before proceeding to the next lesson, answer the following question. Remember, please type your answer in the link provided. The last part of the lesson is the parts of our motherboard. The computer motherboard, or shortly MOLBO, is one of the most important parts of the personal computer. It is the hardware of the computer installed inside the system unit, or the CPU. This MOLBO hardware acts as the main board, or the central or core assembly of the computer system unit. Let's talk about the first part of our motherboard, the ports. We have here the different parts of the motherboard ports. We have here the PS2 port. The PS2 port used to connect the mouse, the green color, and the keyboard, the purple color. Next, the VGA port built in. This is used to interface the DB cord of the monitor screen or to connect the monitor screen of the computer. The fastest the video card version are based on the standard of VGA slots. Example, the AGP or the PCI Express card. Next is the DVI port built in. This is a video display interface developed by the Digital Display Working Group. It is used to connect a video source such as computer monitor. This is a video display interface developed by the Digital Display Working Group. It is used to connect a video source such as computer monitor. Next port is the USB 3.0. It is the third major version of the USB standard for interfacing computers and electronic devices. USB 3.0 adds the new transfer rate referred to as a super speed USB. Next port is the USB 2.0 times 2 ports. These are the ports of USB devices of the computer. Attached externally of the system unit, one of that is the USB flash drive. As of now, the versions of the speed of the USB are 1.0 and 2.0 compatible. Next part of the motherboard ports is the audio ports. This is used to connect the speaker, the microphone, the MIDI or the musical instrument digital interface device of the computer. Next is the LAN port. LAN stands for the word Local Area Network. LAN port is a local area network of the computer. This is used to connect the numbers of nodes or workstations to form a local area network of the computer within their area. Using a type of communication media such as the network switch and router. Okay, we have the ports. We have the 8 pins plus 12 volts power cable. Next is the CPU socket or the FM2 socket. Next is the name of the form factor FM2 plus or FM2. Next is the memory slot. Next is the 24-pin ATX main power cable. Next is the SATA port built in. It used to connect the hard disk drive. Next is the PCI Express x16. Next is the motherboard NordBridge. The SATA port built in. The PCI. The front panel connectors. The front USB, the front audio, and the PCI Express x1. So my dear students, those are the parts of our motherboard. My dear learners, that's the end of our lesson. But before we are going to end our lesson, may I check first your understanding about the parts of the motherboard. Your timer starts now. Thank you. Are you done, my dear learners? Great! Good job! Now, please perform the additional activity. So, I will give you 5 minutes to do the task. You, my dear learners, will create a short video presentation, 2 to 3 minutes, about what you have learned in our lesson. I repeat, learners, create a short video presentation, 2 to 3 minutes, about what you have learned in our lesson. My dear learners, it has been another knowledge-filled day. I believe you were able to grasp all the concepts of our lesson all about motherboards. You will surely be using them in understanding the succeeding episodes. Until next time, my dear learners, this is your teacher, Albert Arellano Gluba, saying always dare to be impressively and responsively different because, remember, you always shine in your special way. Goodbye and God bless.